All right, Matt, thank you very much. It is time now for our Sunrise Smart Start.
Gates police are investigating what could have been a deadly tragedy. Someone fired a gun in the Diplomat Party House around 1:30 Sunday morning. Nearly 400 people were there for a concert. Police say patrons took over the bar and began throwing bottles of alcohol, hitting one woman in the head. At least 5 gunshots were fired, but we're told no one was hit.
An employee at Thompson Hospital, who is also an athletic trainer in the Geneseo School District, has been arrested on rape charges. Livingston County Sheriff's deputies say 30-year-old Austin Pratt of Wayland had a sexual encounter with a child under the age of 17. The alleged incident happened last month. Pratt was arraigned yesterday.
The man arrested in connection with a local Amber Alert due in federal court today on child pornography charges. Police say Robert Gonzalez took a 14-year-old girl to New York City early last month, setting off a statewide search and Amber Alert. Prosecutors said numerous videos of sexual encounters between Gonzalez and that 14-year-old girl were found on his phone when he was arrested. He's scheduled to appear in federal court at 9 o'clock this morning.
Also today, lawmakers will decide whether to allow early voting here in New York. The Senate and Assembly plan to vote on the measure, which is designed to drive up election turnout. Under the bill, voters could cast a ballot up to 10 days before an election. Most states already allow advance voting.
Governor Cuomo and the state legislature rolling out the budget this week. This time it includes a proposal to ban plastic bags. The proposal also includes an expansion to the bottle bill that would make most non-alcoholic drink bottles eligible for a 5-cent return. The proposal is part of the state budget, which the governor will present tomorrow.
Well, now that winter is here on full blast, your furnace is probably on full blast as well. That's why News 8 is putting you first. How you can make sure you're not just burning money with an inefficient heating system. Heating help from 5 to 6:30 today on News 8.
And hopefully your furnace is working this morning. It is cold out there.
It sure is. Yeah, we've got single-digit temperatures in many spots, especially south of Rochester this morning where the sky is cleared. In Rochester itself, it is cloudy, but that cloud cover acting like a blanket, keeping the temperature a little bit higher here into the low 20s right now in town this morning as you head out the door. There is that low cloud cover. You can see it very nicely on satellite, overcast right now in places like Geneva, but down in Dansville and in places like Leroy, the sky is clear. So there should be at least some sunshine here as we work our way through this day today. Temperatures will top out in the mid-20s for highs, a quiet day. A January caliber of chill, but again, not too tough to take, all things considered.
Especially since there's going to be a little bit of sunshine.
Especially since we've got a little sun and might get a little stormy by the weekend, so something we're going to be following.
Something you're watching closely.
That's right.
Yeah. All right, thank you so much. And thank you for watching News 8 at Sunrise.
Our next update is coming up in 25 minutes. CBS This Morning starts right now. Have a great day.